Friends, we will cover Chapter 5, Kingdoms, Kings and an Early Republic of NCERT Class 6th History. Now, in the previous chapter, we had studied the period of Rig Veda that was around 3500 years ago. Now, we will study the period of around 3000 years ago. Before that, you should remember that NCERT has taken the year of reference as the year 2000. Okay, so around this period, that is 3000 years ago, what happened that priests have divided the society into four parts that were called varnas. Okay, remember that these classification were done by the priests of that time. So what was that? At the top of the pyramid were the Brahmins. These were expected to study and teach the Vedas. They also performed sacrifices for Rajas and they also received the gifts. Second on the pyramid were the Kshatriyas. These were fighting battles and protecting the people. And third on the pyramid were the Vish or the Vaishyas. They were also called Jan, as we have studied in the previous chapter. And they were farmers, herders and traders. They were the common people basically. And at the bottom of the pyramid, they were the fourth category, that is Shudras. They served all the above three groups and they could not perform any ritual or sacrifice. Often women were also categorized into this group only. And they were not allowed to study the Vedas also. So notice an important change here, friends. We have seen the importance of women in the Rig Veda period. Okay, there they used to wrote hymns and suktas in Rig Veda. But here they were categorized into the Shudras category. So this was an important change you should keep in mind. Now, we will study about some definition or some called Janpats. Okay, this is the land where the Jan set its foot. What were the Jan? We have read this definition in the previous chapter. Jan were the group of people or community. Okay, wherever they went and they settled down, that was called a Janpad. So some examples that archaeologists have found were Purana Kila in Delhi, Hastinapur and Atranji Khera in UP. These all were sample Janpats. Okay, now how was the life in these Janpats? Their people used to keep cattle. Okay, we have seen the importance of cattle in the previous chapter. Okay, there were battles for cattle also. And they used to grow variety of crops. And one thing to be noticed here that sugar cane, this crop was not in the Harappan cities. Okay. So this is a new development. Sugarcane crop came to be grown now. And Rajas, how they became Rajas now? They were became Rajas or recognized Rajas by performing very big sacrifices like Ashwamedh or horse sacrifice. Okay. So they used to impose their supremacy on the Jan or the common people. Now, people also used to make the earthen pots and some special type of pottery has been found at these sites. That is, for example, plates and bowls. Okay. And there were designs of simple lines and geometric patterns that have been discovered in this special type of pottery. These were grouped into the name as painted grayware. You can see the picture here. Okay, this is a sample of painted grayware. So you should keep these points in the mind. Now we will study about a period of around 2500 years ago. Okay, friends, again remember that NCERT has taken the reference year as 2000. Currently we are in year 2020. So now we will study about Mahajanpats. Okay, about 2500 years ago, some Janpats became more important than others and these were known as Mahajanpats. Okay, some of them are shown in the previous slide. For example, you see here some of important Janpats or Mahajanpats were Magadha, Kosala, Panchal, Gandhar. Okay, these were the important Mahajanpats that came to be around that period. Notice that these Janpats and Mahajanpats, all these developed along the banks of the rivers. And most Mahajanpats had a capital city and many of these were fortified. That is, they had a huge wall of wood, brick or stone around them. See, they were fortified. Now, this is an important point, friends, as the fold building, which was not seen earlier, it now emerged and it led to the need for all types of resources like labor, army, food, etc. Okay, hence the new Rajas now began maintaining armies. Okay, now army system came into picture and there is something called punch marked coins. Okay, these came into use for salary payments to soldiers. Now soldiers were being kept by the Rajas for army purpose and they were also given proper salary. These coins we will study in details about them in chapter 8 later on. Now there were two changes in the agriculture around this period. One was the growing use of iron plowshares. We have covered earlier that in Harappan cities there were wooden plow for digging the earth. Now, this meant that heavy clay soil could be turned over better than with a wooden plowshare, so that more grain could be produced. And second major change was that now people began transplanting paddy with the help of slaves. This meant that instead of scattering seed on the ground from the plants from which plants would sprout, saplings were grown first and then they were planted in the fields. This led to the increased production, as many more plants survived with this method than they survived by scattering the seeds on the ground. Okay friends, so just remember these points. This is a very important slide of this chapter. Now friends, as the rulers of the Mahajanapads were building huge forts, we have seen they were maintaining big armies also, so they needed more resources. Okay, hence they started collecting taxes. Tax on crop was the most important. Okay, these were paid by the farmers, because most people were farmers, and so they gave around 1/6 of the produce to the king. There were other people also who used to pay the tax in some or other form to rajas, like they were craft persons, okay, traders, herders and hunter gatherers. They used to give forest produce like fruits or food to the king. Now friends, I hope you can now solve this question. The two ways in which the Raja of the Mahajanapads were different from Rig Veda Raja. Okay, just pause the video and read this slide. You will understand the differences. Now we will friends cover about the period of around 2300 years ago. See, we have started with 3000, then we studied 2500 years ago. Now we are studying a period of 2300 years ago. So in a period of 200 years, the major Mahajanapad that developed around that time period was called Magadha. Okay, it was a Mahajanapad that turned into a very big kingdom. Now we will see the point by point the causes of the Magadha becoming a big kingdom. What were the causes? It can be categorized into three main list basically. Number one was the location. Location was very fruitful for Magadha. It was on Ganga and its tributary Son, which provided transportation for goods and fertile land for crops. Second reason was huge forest resource. Okay, they had trained elephant for maintaining the army. Okay, they received wood for houses and building carts. Okay, for army purpose. And third reason was availability of iron ore mines for building tools and weapons. We have seen the importance of iron now. They were using the iron plowshares also. There were iron tools. In earlier chapter, we have discovered that in megalithic sites, now iron came to be in picture. Okay, so we had found tools and weapons in burial sites also in previous picture, if you recall. So second are the rulers in Magadha. So there are some sample rulers' names you should remember. Bimbisara, Ajatasattu and Mahapadmananda. These were the three important rulers of Magadha. What was the capital city of Magadha? Rajagriha, present day Rajgir in Bihar. It was later shifted to Pataliputra, that is present day Patna. Now friends, there is an important point that a ruler from Europe who came up to river Bias in Indian subcontinent. He was the Alexander. There was invasion of Alexander around this period only, when the Magadha was a big kingdom. But he returned back, as the rulers of India had vast armies of soldiers, chariots and elephants. So this is an important point. This shows the importance of the Magadha kingdom, how big there were the army and how strong and powerful the kingdom was. Okay, so in what ways were the armies different from those described in the Rig Veda, friends? In the Rig Veda, there was no regular army. Now we had some regular army of soldiers, chariots and elephants. Now friends, parallelly there was another political system running in Bihar around this period, that is Gana or Sangha system. We will study them one by one. What is the definition of Gana, friends? It is basically nothing but a group that has many members, like a group of monks or a group of nuns. It is called Gana. And what is Sangha? It means an organization or association. It in present day you can relate it with the RSS. Okay, it is a Sangha. So friends, there was a place in Bihar that is called Vaji. Okay, there was a different political system being followed. It followed a Gana or Sangha form of government. There were not one but many rulers. Okay, so even thousands of people were called Raja. Each one of them was called Raja. Okay, they performed rituals together and they met in assemblies for discussing any important issue. And please notice that women and das or slave people, they were excluded from these assemblies. So still women was not given the that much importance. And friends, Buddha and Mahavira, these have belonged to this system of governance only. About them we will study in the later on chapters. Friends, around this period, a very important book called the Digha Nikaya. It is a famous Buddhist book which contains the speeches of Buddha. It was composed around this period, that is 2300 years ago only. Now, friends, based on our study, we will solve this question that in what ways was the Vajji Sangha different from the Mahajanapads? We have seen they had followed the Sangha form of government. There were many rulers together, but Mahajanapad, they had a single ruler, single powerful ruler, okay? There in Sangha, they met in assemblies for taking important decisions, but their king was responsible for all the decisions. And in Mahajanapad, their rulers tried to conquer the other kingdoms. But Vajji Sangha rulers, they followed some certain principles. They were united and strong, okay? And they were strong enough not to be defeated easily by any kingdom. But until 1500 years ago, the last of the Sangha was conquered by the Gupta rulers. We will study about them in the later on chapters. So friends, I think the chapter is completed now. Hope you have learnt a lot about from this video. Thank you.